In this tutorial, I'll teach you a trick that you can apply to any song or sound effect. You've probably found yourself wanting to finish a video, but the song you've chosen still has a long way to go. Using this reverb effect from DaVinci Resolve, you can end the song naturally, because if we cut the song abruptly, it will end up sounding bad. We can't finish the video this way, it's not professional. Now I'll show you how to correctly apply the reverb effect. Let's get started. First, we'll zoom in on our timeline to better see the audio waves of the song. Okay, select the blade edit mode, and the next step is to cut the final part of the song. A 1 to 2 second cut is usually enough. It's important to pay attention to the beats and rhythm of the song. We must avoid ending the song at a random point. We need to look for and cut it at a moment where the rhythm has a strong beat. Pay close attention to this part here. If we analyze the audio waves, we can see there's a strong rise, that is, a strong beat in the song. For this reason, I've decided to end it right at this moment. Okay, we can deactivate the blade tool. Next, we need to duplicate this last piece of the song we've cut. You can copy and paste the piece, or use a keyboard shortcut to make the process easier. Simply hold down the Alt key on Windows or Command key on Mac, select the clip, and drag it to a new place on the timeline. This will automatically create a copy of the clip. Perfect. Next, we'll extend the duration of the new clip we just created. This step is necessary to properly apply the reverb effect. The clip on top will be the original clip. We won't make any changes to this clip. However, the clip below, the one we've extended, will be the one we'll use to apply the reverb effect. You might be wondering why we've extended this part of the song. The reason is that we'll add the echo of the reverb effect to this part. But to only hear the echo and stop the song from playing, we need to lower the volume of this extended part. It's very simple. We position ourselves right at the frame where we've decided to end the song. Move one frame forward. Create a keyframe on the extended clip. And move another frame forward. Now, simply lower the volume to the minimum. This way, we'll have all this space where the echo of the reverb effect can resonate. Great, we're done. And everything is ready to apply the echo effect. We go to the effects menu. Here, we'll click on the Audio FX section. We need to look for the reverb effect. To find it more easily, you can use the search bar at the top. Now, simply select the effect and drag it onto the long clip in the timeline. Perfect. Once the reverb effect is applied, a menu with various configuration options will open. The first setting we need to modify is the room size. The larger it is, the more echo, and vice versa. Setting it to a value of 65 square meters usually works well for this type of effect. The second modification we need to make is to adjust the duration of the echo effect. The longer the blue graph horizontally, the longer the echo will last. To increase the echo duration, we will adjust the reverb time setting to an approximate value of 2,500. We'll see that the blue graph extends. Now the echo will last longer. Keep in mind that these values are approximate. Depending on the type of song, it's better to tweak these values a bit. Although there are many more options available for configuration, with these two main adjustments, we will have significantly improved the reverb effect in our song. Lastly, I recommend slightly decreasing the overall output value. The dry/wet control adjust the mix between the processed, wet, and original, dry signal. By finding a middle point, we will ensure that the reverb effect is balanced, not too subtle nor too exaggerated. Done! We have it now. If you close the menu and then need to reopen it to adjust the values and test which configuration sounds best, you can do so by clicking on this icon here. Well, now comes the hardest part of the tutorial. Listening to how our reverb effect turned out. Let's go to it. perfect. It has improved a lot. Now the song ends correctly. If you want to learn more effects from DaVinci Resolve, here are free tutorials where you can learn lots of new things. See you in the next video.